Hey guys, Dan Vallimont here with Fanatic Wrestling. Just finishing up filming a instructional video with Mario Mason, fellow Jersey wrestler. We're down here at Rhino Wrestling Club in New Jersey, my home state. And I just want to go over one of my favorite techniques here, a nice inside trip from an over-under position. Very common position in wrestling, and a lot of guys just don't really know what they're doing there. So a lot of times you'll get guys here in this over-under, and they just kind of hang out here unless they feel really safe as an upper body wrestler. Me, personally, I don't really hit that much from here as far as throws, and this is probably about as close as I get to doing something like that. So, just getting into this again, I said it's going to be an inside trip. There's a lot of different ways to do trips from here, and I think I'm in the minority of people that kind of, I trip the opposite side that most people do. So when you're watching this, keep that in mind, that it's typically, most people, if they're in this over-under, they're going to hit their trip to the same side as the overhook. So if I was going to do that, I would be tripping with my left foot to his right foot. I actually like to do it the opposite way. I learned from this guy named Oishi, a guy that wrestled in Japan and came and coached at Penn State. He taught me a certain way to do it, and it just stuck with me when I was younger. And so that's just kind of how I hit it here to the opposite side. So the way I like to set this up, it can work if he's a left or a right foot lead, but I actually prefer to be wrestling a right foot wrestler here because I can help set it up a little bit more. So we're in this over-under position. We're not standing straight up. We're in a good stance here. I'm just kind of fighting for position. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my hand that's on the outside or my overhook side, and I'm going to reach right behind this guy's knee. Now, I don't expect to be able to grab his leg and pull it towards me. This is just a setup to get him to react and step back. All right, so I'm coming here, and as he steps back, I'm not gonna just let go of it. I'm actually gonna let him pull me into him. It's kind of hard to do this slow, but you'll see what I mean. As he's pulling me in, I'm gonna do a little crow step here, bring my feet closer together, and then I'm actually gonna do my trip and finish there. So again, it's hard to do slow, but he's leading this right foot. We're in this over-under position. I come to the back of his knee. I bring my feet closer together, do that little crow hop here. I let him pull me in, bring your foot forward again. So here, he steps back, I step in, and then we're finishing our inside trip. So again, from the opposite side, it's a little hard to do this slowly, but when I'm doing my trip, I'm trying to get my knee, the back of my leg, right where my leg bends, on the back of his calf knee. And sinking the whole way down, kind of sagging into this position. And then my hands, I'm gonna try to lock into a body lock as I'm finishing. And another question I get a lot is, what side does your head finish on? My head kind of finishes right in the middle of his chest. So again, here in this over-under position, I'm going to reach for his lead leg. He steps back. I'm not going to step over it. I'm going to use that momentum to pull me in, do my heels together, step in, trip with his foot. So here, step, and then bottom up, my head goes to the center. If you're lucky enough to catch him on the back, his body lock position there, you might be able to pin him or get some backs. Or sometimes a guy will just belly out. But again, great technique in here. And a lot of guys don't expect it because it's the opposite side. So one last time here. Step, here, into our trick, and finish. So thanks for watching, guys. Stay on the lookout for more content. Hope to see you soon.